Okay, so last video we talked about the average rate of change. And in this video I want to talk about one more form for slope, which is the difference quotient. And I want to do something slightly different, okay? So in the last example we used, these 2 points, right? I again have these 2 points associated with my slope. Oops, x1, y1, and x2, y2. And in the secant line or in the average rate of change, I used this point at A, f of A, and B, f of B. Okay, we have one more form of slope that we talk about a lot in calculus, and that's called the difference quotient. Now, the difference quotient is an example of an average rate of change. But in the difference quotient, we're thinking in our heads that A and B are really close together. We'll talk about limits in the next section, and you'll see kind of how that works. But here, I just want to think of them as being really, really super close together. Okay? So in that case, I let maybe A or let x1 be some ordinary x value. And then x2 is pretty close to that x. Okay? So this is my new, just so that I'm saying, I'm using some random x here. And x2 is really close to that x value. It's x plus a little. And in the context of calculus, the letter that we use to stand for, like a little bit, is x plus h. And in my head, I'm thinking that these are small values. Okay? And then if I use those for my x values, then my y1 is f of x. We're still talking about functions. And my y2 is f of x plus h. Okay, and then that means the difference quotient looks something like this. Let's write it down. The actual difference quotient from slope again, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And the difference quotient is f of x plus h minus f of x divided by x plus h minus x. This denominator simplifies, so most of the time you'll see this written as f of x plus h minus f of x, and I get x minus x, those cancel, and I just get an h down here. This right here is the difference quotient, f of x plus h minus f of x, all divided by h. Okay? So let's calculate or find a couple of difference quotients. Find the difference quotient for f of x is equal to 4x plus 3. Okay? So you'll see in these problems that x still remains a variable. We don't have the concrete numbers that we do in average rates of change. But that this is kind of a quantity involving x as a variable. Okay. So I find the difference quotient for f of x is equal to 4x plus 4. So 4x plus 3. So let me remind you, the difference quotient is f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. Okay? So there are three quantities here. I always know h, it will just be left alone. I don't have a specific value to put in there. I know f of x right here. I need to find f of x plus h. Okay, so let me do that. F of x plus h is equal to 4 times x plus h plus 3. And that's 4x plus 4h plus 3. And I encourage you to expand that as much as you can. You'll be doing the subtraction in the numerator, and it's easier to do if you expand it there. Okay, so now back to the difference quotient, which I will call DQ. And I'll always think of Dairy Queen when I'm saying that, but in this context, difference quotient. Okay, so I want to put in f of x plus h, right? So for f of x plus h, I put in what I just found, 4x plus 4h plus 3 in parentheses, minus f of x in parentheses, 4x plus 3, all divided by h. Open up your parentheses, distribute this minus, and simplify. 4x plus 4h plus 3 minus 4x minus 3 divided by h. I'm going to get a little bit more room and then we're going to simplify this. Your 4x is, if you see, I have a 4x and a minus 4x, and I have a 3 minus 3. So those will cancel. I'll be left with 4h divided by h. H is a factor in both numerator and denominator, and the difference quotient is just 4 in this particular problem. Okay? Okay, let's do one more difference quotient that's a little bit more complicated. Or a little bit messier, maybe. Example, find the difference quotient. Again, this is just the slope when my two points are really close together, okay? For f of x is equal to x squared minus x plus 4. Okay, again, difference quotient. F of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So find f of x plus h. And so I plug in x plus h everywhere I see x in the problem. So I get x plus h quantity squared minus the quantity x plus h plus 4. And now I'm going to FOIL out this x plus h squared to get x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. I'll distribute this minus, minus x minus h plus 4. I don't think anything will combine here. And I'll go ahead and put that into the actual difference quotient. So back to the difference quotient. So in f of x plus h, I'm going to put this big, long, algebraic expression that I just found, minus, and my original f of x is x squared minus x plus 4 all over h. Okay, remove parentheses and you should see some cancellation happening. For some functions, it's harder to cancel than others. Okay, so let me try and draw these connections. Here's an x squared and there's an x squared that will cancel. There's a minus x and a plus x. And here's a plus 4 and a minus 4. Otherwise, I think everything stays, so let me write that down. That's the stuff that gets canceled out. So I get 2xh plus h squared minus h, and I think that's it. All over h. I want to cancel. There's h's floating around, so factor out this h in the numerator. Oops, 2x plus just a regular h minus 1 divided by h. Now I can cancel them. And I get left with 2x minus 1 plus h. And I probably will write the plus h at the end. It's fine to have x and h both in what's left of your difference quotient. Okay? So again, these are the three forms for slope. We talked about the average rate of change of a function. We talked about the secant line there. And we talked about the difference quotient as well. So please let me know if you have any questions about this stuff.